presentation today is clear and well organized, unlike my English. At present, irate LDPC codes are increasingly used in the transmission system, and in our paper we propose a new method to derive a puncturing pattern given the parity metrics of a base code. The presentation is organized in this mode. The first part discusses the irate puncturing method and its relationship to existing method. The second part describes a real-world scenario with application of the proposed method to microwave radio link for a mobile network backhaul. And the third part presents the simulation and measurement results. The puncturing is a common scheme which produces a code with higher code rate, starting from a base code with lower rate. Particularly, our method extracts a puncturing pattern which is optimized in terms of error floor performance and satisfies some constraint which result in an important reduction of hardware complexity. To develop this method, we started from Bellamby et al. Paper, which present a rate-compatible puncturing scheme. This scheme uses the idea that the degradation in performance is reduced by selecting a puncturing pattern wherein the puncture bits are far apart from each other in the Tanner graph of the code. And this choice ensures that no small cycles are introduced when the code is punctured. In summary, the puncturing scheme presented by Bellamby et al. Takes in a parity matrix of a LDPC code and returns a set of bit indices to be punctured. It's easy to implement and allow room for fine-tuning depending on the parent code to be implemented. We extended this algorithm to obtain a good puncturing pattern that can reach higher code rate by relaxing some of the problem condition. In the proposed new puncturing scheme, the pattern is designed so that the homogeneous clusters of consecutive bit are punctured and the main effect is to fold. More degree of freedom in the choice of the puncturing pattern are allowed and the hardware implementation complexity is reduced, since the number of puncturing positions to be stored is smaller by a factor which depends on the cluster size. Our method presents two main phases. In the first phase, it finds a set of puncture bit indices with Bellamby et al. Method, and then enumerates all clusters which contain at least one puncture bits. In the second phase, the cluster's selection is made. The cluster with a greater number of puncture bits are picked first, and the remaining cluster needed to reach the target code rate are selected so that the number of parity check affected by puncture bits is minimized. In fact, this selection method to select is based on the observation that the coding will better converge if the number of parity check with puncture bits is minimized, because this reduces the number of bits which in the decoding process are affected by punctured position. This heuristic observation has been validated through simulations and hardware tests. Now, as an example, we present an application of the proposed method to high code rate LDPC code used in the microwave transmission point-to-point radio link. Note that our algorithm can be applied to LDPC codes of any block length and code rate. In this case, we start from a given LDPC code with code rate 15 over 16, set the dimension of cluster to 8 bit, and select 19 over 20 as the target code rate after puncturing. The parent code is a regular LDPC code with quasi-cyclic structure, message length of 7,665 bits, coded block length of 8,176 bits, and its parity matrix is free from four cycles, and it built with a single row of 16 circulants of size 511 and column weight 4. So, in order to increase the code rate to 19 over 20, we need to puncture 88 parity bits out of 511. And these parity bits can be grouped in 64 clusters, where each cluster corresponds to one byte, with the exception of the last one, which has only 7 valid bits. As to tell before, in the second step of the algorithm, the cluster selection is made, and this step is based on the indices structure. In fact, the algorithm uses the index to count the puncture bits for every byte. Starting from this application example, the simulations were run using the C++ simulation library, 20 iterations for belief propagation decoding, and using full precision LLR generation. The puncture code bear as a function of the puncturing pattern was simulated in two different test cases. In the first case, we selected 128 QAM modulation in Gaussian channel, and in the second case, we selected 256 QAM modulation in Gaussian channel. And through our algorithm, we extracted 6 puncturing patterns. About this, it's important to tell that 3 target parameters define the extractor: number of parity check involved, number of puncture bytes, and number of initial puncture bits involved in the different puncture bytes. Particularly, the first 2 tables show the extractor of each pattern based on the first 2 parameters. The number of puncture bytes is equal to 11 because we need to reach 19 over 20 as the target code rate after puncturing. And the number of parity check affected by puncture bits is equal to, for example, 280 in the pattern 2, 281 in the pattern 4, and 269 in the pattern 6. Instead, the second 2 tables show the number of initial puncture bits involved in the different puncture bytes. For example, in the pattern 2, each byte involves 3 initial puncture bits. Instead, in the pattern 4, there is 1 byte with 5 initial puncture bits, and there are 10 bytes with 3 initial puncture bits. As to tell before, the puncture code bear as a function of the puncturing pattern was simulated in 2 different test cases. In the first, let us consider the first test case and the first 3 puncturing pattern. The results show that the use of the puncturing scheme that involves the least number of parity check is a necessary but not sufficient condition to obtain a good performance. In fact, not considering the error floor behavior, the best performance is obtained with the pattern 2 that involves 280 parity check. But if we consider the error floor, the scenario is different. Comparing the simulation results for the different puncturing pattern involving more or less the same number of parity check, we can see that the best performance is obtained with the pattern 3, that it composed with bytes involving the greatest number of initial puncture bits. Now let us consider the second group of puncturing pattern. Also in this case, the results confirm that in order to obtain a good performance, it's necessary to choose the puncturing scheme that involves the least number of parity check and that it composed with bytes involving the greatest number of initial puncture bits. As we will see in the next slides, the hardware measurements show that the best pattern is P4, and in fact it represents the best trade-off between the involved number of parity check and the number of initial puncture bits. Now, let us consider the second test case and the two previous group of puncturing pattern. As we have shown in the former test case, the result confirm that the best performance is obtained with the puncturing scheme that involves the least number of parity check and the greatest number of initial puncture bits involved in the different puncture bytes. However, it's clear that the simulation results have a limited capability to identify the pattern that provides the best performance for a large value of signal noise ratio. Therefore, in order to check the high SNR behavior, it's necessary to test the puncturing pattern in hardware. To verify the LDPC pattern performance, we used a FPGA-based emulation platform that implements a modulator and demodulator for MQAM modulation and include a LDPC decoder. Note that 20 iterations are used for the belief propagation decoding. In this test, we used the free puncturing pattern that provides the best performance in the previous simulation, and we selected the same test cases. We can see that the hardware measurements are in agreement with the simulation results already discussed, and they confirm that in order to obtain a good performance, it's necessary to use the puncturing scheme that involves the least number of parity check affected by puncture bits and the greatest number of initial puncture bits involved in the different puncture bytes. In fact, the results confirm that the best pattern is P4 because it represents the best trade-off between the involved number of parity check and the greatest number of initial puncture bits. To conclude, starting from the puncturing scheme presented by Vellanby et al., we have proposed a new algorithm which produces a good puncturing pattern that involves clusters of bits. This solution offers more flexibility and a reduced hardware implementation complexity because it allows a reduced set of puncturing positions to be stored. Moreover, the simulation and measurements result show that to obtain a good puncturing pattern, the cluster should be selected so that the number of puncture bits in the set is maximized and the number of parity check affected by puncture bits is minimized. This choice remains true also in the error flow region of the code, where the resulting pattern show a good performance. That's all. Thank you for your attention.